Hello all. In this assignment, we are going to look at the VPC peering. So as explained in the lecture, if you do VPC peering, the instances in the private subnets from these two VPCs can talk to each other over the private IPs. So typically this is required for security purpose, like if you don't want to allow access to your instances inside a VPC, but still you want to connect to that VPC, right? Then you can do something like this. So if you see this diagram, there are two VPCs, VPC A and VPC B, and in this assignment we are going to see how a private instance in VPC A can talk to a private instance in VPC B. So if you see, in VPC B there is no internet gateway and there is no public subnet, right? So the only way to reach to this EC2B instance is via EC2A instance. Okay, so for this assignment, we'll start with creating these two VPCs and then see how to do the VPC peering between them. If you remember the first assignment, the left side VPC exactly same as the first assignment. We have a single VPC, a public subnet and the private subnet. We'll create one instance in a public subnet so that we can connect to that instance over the internet, and from that instance we can reach to the private instance which is in a private subnet. So creating this VPC, I'll go a bit faster and then later on we'll see how to create another VPC and then do the VPC peering. Okay, so to start with, as explained, the two VPCs need not have the overlapping IPC IDR ranges, right? That means you cannot peer two VPCs which have similar or overlapping CIDR. So here we'll be creating 10.100.0.0.16 as a first VPC and 10.200.0.0.16 as a second VPC. We'll call this as an A and this as a B VPC. Okay, so with that, let's create this network diagram. So one thing is, always keep this diagram handy with you whenever you are going to set up the network, because it really helps you to quickly understand what you are doing and how you have to create the whole network in the AWS. So I'll refer this diagram again and again. Okay, so let's actually create this stuff. Okay, so I am in my Mumbai region and this is my default VPC. So what I'm going to do is right now is create a VPC, which is A, VPC A, and the address range is 10.100 here. For VPC B, we'll be using 10.200.0.0.16. Create. Next thing I'm going to do is create an internet gateway. Again, this is IGW for VPC A. Or maybe we'll follow this nomenclature, VPC A IGW, and I'll attach it to the VPC A. Okay, now if you go back to the diagram, we created this VPC. I'll create a public subnet and then I'll create a private subnet. So I go to the subnets, I say create a subnet. So this is VPC A subnet public, and make sure you select the right VPC and you can give the IP CIDR range of 24 here. So this is the first address block available in that VPC. Create. The next thing you have to do is create a route table and associate with the subnet, right? So we'll just create a route table. The name will be again VPCART, and this is a public route table because I'm going to associate it with public subnet. And then I will add a route for the internet, right? So keep doing these things again and again so that you're very familiar with this flow, how it works. You don't forget any steps there. Typically people add the route but then forget to associate with the subnets. So make sure you associate this route table with the right subnet. So I'm associating with the public subnet. Okay, so this part is done. So VPC is created and the public subnet is created. I'm going to create now this private subnet. So again, I go back to the subnet. I say create subnet. So this is a subnet inside VPC, but this is private subnet. So I'll say just private. Select the right VPC, and now the address block, I will take the next available address block. So 10.10.10/24. Just create it. Now again, I create a route table for this private subnet. So again, VPC A route table private. I select the right VPC, create. So as of now, we don't want to add a route for the internet because this is a private subnet, but we need to associate with the correct subnet. So I'm associating it with the private subnet and save it. Okay, so if you see, my whole this network has been set up. Let's again quickly launch these two instances and make sure we are able to reach to this private instance from this instance. Okay, so I go back here. I say launch instance, select, configure, I select right VPC, I select a public subnet. I want to have a public IP, add storage default, add tags, name, so VPC A, EC2, public, you get that right, okay. Security group, now we want to allow VPC A EC2 or say SG public, and what we want to do is allow SSH from my IP because this is the only instance to which I can connect from my private address or sorry my laptop. So review and launch and then just launch the instance. I want to create, so there are some older instances. I just say running. Okay, as of now it's pending. So now I created the first EC2 instance. Now I'll create the second EC2 instance in a private subnet. Okay, so go here, configure instance details. Now you make sure you select the right VPC and a private subnet. You don't want a public IP to this instance. Your rest of the things you keep as it is. Storage default, add tags, name, VPC A, EC2, private, security group. So again, VPC A, SG, private. If you see, we are going to SSH to this instance only from this subnet or say this instance, right? So we'll only allow the SSH to this instance from this CIDR range. So what I want to do is 10.10.0/24. So we're restricting security group to be not to be very open, right? Only public instances from public subnet can connect to this instance over SSH. Review and launch. Okay, so we are back here. If you just filter on the running instances, so this is my public instance, this is in running state, so this will take some time. So by that time these two instances come up, we can go on setting up the second VPC, that is VPC B. So understand that the VPC CIDR range you cannot use the same because then we won't be able to do the VPC peering. However, technically it is possible to reuse the same VPC CIDR for another VPC because they are totally different VPCs. But as we have to do VPC peering, we'll choose a non-overlapping CIDR address 10.200.0.0.16. Okay, and then we'll create one private subnet and launch one EC2 instance with the private IP in that subnet. Okay, let's go back to our VPC wizard. So this is now VPC B and the range is 10.0.0.16. 16. One thing to note that we are not going to have any public subnet here, and that's where we don't need this internet gateway for this instance, because we are not going to connect to this instance from over the internet. Only thing that we want is a private subnet, right? So I'm not going to create an internet gateway here. I'll just directly go to the subnet, create subnet, VPC P subnet private. I'll be selecting VPC B, and I can give the address as 1.0/24. I could also be in 10.200.0.0.24, but I want to be just consistent with this two private subnets, right? This and this. This is in the range of 100.10, so this should be in the range of 200.10. Create. Next thing I want to do is create a route table for this private subnet. This is VPC BRT private, and I select this VPC, create this. So route I'm going to keep it as it is, but I'm going to associate it with this subnet. Okay, so as of now I have this whole network set up. If you see, I have this VPC, both the VPCs. Only thing remaining is its VPC peering. But before that, let's launch this EC2 instance here. So I'm going here, launch instance, select, configure. Now I'm going to select VPC B. It has only one subnet, so it will show that. I don't want to give any public IP to this instance. Add storage, add tag. So the name tag, and this is VPCP EC2 private, configure security group, VPC BSG private. So if you see this diagram, we want to connect to this instance from this instance, or say from the subnet. So we will allow two ports, one for SSH and other we should be able to ping as well, right? So that when we ultimately reach to EC2A private instance, it should be able to SSH to this instance. So in the security group of this EC2B instance, we will allow SSH and the ping from this subnet, this CIDR range. So for that, we'll say 10, 100, make sure it's an 100, right? This is a subnet range from the first VPC, VPC A, 1.0/24, right? That's where this network diagram helps you. You don't have to remember a lot of things. And then I will also allow the all ICMP, that is for a ping request from the same subnet. Review and launch. Launch. Okay. So by the time this is coming up, let's just try to get to the VPCA private instance. So for that, we need to first connect to this public instance over the public IP. So what we are doing is we are logging into this instance or the public IP, and from there we log into this instance. So if you remember, this is exactly same as what we did in the first exercise. So I'm just going to the PuTTY, putting this IP address. I'm just doing the connection 30 so that it does not break my connection. It sends the keep alive message every 30 seconds. It helps you if your connection is breaking. If you see PuTTY session, just tweak these settings. Then SSH, and I'm selecting this Mumbai demo 1 key. Open. User is EC2-user. Okay, so if you see, I am into this machine, and this is 10.0.0.12 is private IP of this first machine, which is nothing but this machine. Now from here I want to SSH to this machine. So first let's get the IP address of this second machine. So the IP address of this machine is this 10.1.1.94. So I'm just doing ec2-user and this. Do you think we should be able to connect it? If you guess no, we can't, then you're right. And the reason, we don't have SSH key to connect. That's where it says permission denied. So first thing we'll do is we'll create a demo1 PAM file. So we can copy the PAM file which we had downloaded earlier. So I have this Mumbai PAM file here. So note that this is not a PPK file. You are now connecting from Unix to Unix. So you will have the PAM key, PAM SSH key. So I'm just doing VI. I'm just putting this content here. And I need to change the permission either 600 or 400. Otherwise SSH does not work. Okay. And now I need to provide this SSH key for logging into this machine. Okay, so if you see this IP of this machine 10.1.1.94, that is exactly the same IP address of this EC2 private instance. So according to this diagram, we are in here, right? So ultimately what we want to try is we want to connect to this EC2 machine from here. So let's see if we are able to do that. For that, I need an IP address of this EC2B machine. So I'm going back to my console. I'll just refresh it so that I have third instance. So this is EC2B private instance and its IP is this. So if I do just SSH, I can't connect. If I do ping, I can't connect. That's because we don't have any connectivity between these two VPCs as of now. These are totally separate VPCs, right? We can't reach to this instance as of now because we don't even have the route from the public. So only thing we can reach to this instance, we would have to do the VPC peering between these two VPCs. And that's what now we are going to do. Okay, so let's go back to our console. Let's go back to our VPCs. There, if you scroll down, there is something called peering connection. So this is an older peering connection. What I'm going to do is create a new peering connection. So this is VPC A, VPC B peering. You can give any name. Now we have to give which VPC is requesting this peering. So there are two entities, the requester and the acceptor. So who originates the request is a requester. So we'll be originating request from this VPC. I mean, in real life scenario, maybe you want to connect to your customer's VPC because you want to talk to over a private network, right? So in that case, you would be the requester and the customer's VPC will be the acceptor. Or it could be other way around. Customer will create a request to connect, but then acceptor has an requester can send request to any VPCs, but then acceptor has to decide whether he wants to allow that connection from the requester, right? So the requester is VPC A, and so as of now, I mean few months back, if you see, it was only allowed to have the VPC peering connection between VPCs in the same AWS region. But recently, just 3 days back, AWS has announced that there are additional 9 regions in which you can do VPC peering across AWS region. So that's a huge advantage, where there is no need to have a VPN connection between the private networks. So if you get a chance, if you see like people are connecting to VPCs over a VPN, then this is a best chance. They just remove the VPN and use VPC peering between the two VPCs. So the acceptor VPC is VPC P. You see there are different IP CIDR ranges here. Create VPC peering connections. Okay. And now this VPC peering connection is pending for acceptance because I am owning both the VPCs. So I will see this acceptance request. If you are sending the request to your customer's VPC, he will see the pending acceptance request. So I'm just going here and accept the request. As soon as I accept the request, it becomes active, right? And then I need to have this VPC peering connection. I can just copy it maybe. Okay, so now what we have done so far is we created this VPC peering connection. Okay, so as of now, what we have done is we created a VPC peering connection between these two, but there is one piece still missing, and that's what, that's about the updating your route tables. So as you know, for any traffic to flow to and from your subnets, it has to has the proper route. So in order to, for a traffic to reach from this subnet to this subnet or from this subnet to this subnet, we need to update corresponding route tables for the subnets. So for this subnet, VPC, a private subnet, we need to add a route to reach to this subnet, and the other way around. In this subnet, we would have to add a route to reach to this subnet through this VPC peering. So let's do that. So if you see, I'm still there in the same instance, and I'm still not able to ping the instance. That's because there is no route to reach to the another subnet in the another VPC. This is an IP address from VPC B. So let's go back to our route tables. So I need to first modify the VPC A private route table route, and I need to add a route for another subnet which is in VPC B, and there its IP address, if you see the range, is this one. If you're not sure, just go back to your diagram and see this address range, 10.200.1.0.24, right? 10.200.1. And now the target, I want this traffic to flow through this VPC peering. So that's a crucial part, and save it. And this route table is already associated with this subnet, so no need to change anything. And now the same thing I would have to do for VPC B private route table. I go to the route there, also I have just a local route, edit, and now I would have to add a route entry for VPC A private subnet, that is 10.100.1.0.24. Again, look at this, 10.100.1.0.24. Again, you see the VPC peering, and you save it. Now we are complete with respect to what networking we wanted to set up. And if everything works fine, oh, it's already started pinging to this instance. That's great. I mean, we are now able to connect from this instance to this instance over a ping. Let's again try just a quick SSH as well. So I'll do SSH /user@this. As you, some of you might have guessed, we won't be able to do it again for the same reason. We don't have SSH key here. So we'll again do create an SSH key demo PAM file. I have already this PAM file opened here. I just paste it here. I just change its permission to 400. And I do SSH with -i demo 1 bang bang. I'm there, I'm into this instance, right? If you see, I'm into this instance. So how I went there, from here I connected here to VPC A public instance, VPC A private instance, then we did the VPC peering setup, added routes, and then from here I'm connecting to this instance in VPC B. Now ideally I should also be able to ping from this instance to this instance. So let's try that. So let's again get the IP address of the private instance of VPC A, which is this. The IP is this. And if I do ping, it does not work. Actually, there is a network connectivity, but it is being blocked at the security group level. So if you go to this instance, if you go to security group, you see inbound rules. There is inbound rules only for the SSH, and that's true from the public subnet of VPCA. You want to allow the ICMP traffic from 10 201.0/24. That is VPC B private subnet, right? Save. As soon as you do that, your traffic is flowing. Cool. Okay. So that means we could complete all this assignment, setting up the VPC pairing. I hope you understood what we did. If not, just get back to me on this. And don't forget to delete all your instances, delete all your networking, because you launched 3 instances in this assignment. Right? Okay. All the best. Thank you.